This little platformer example you see right now was built in Unity, but it is not running in Unity or using its runtime. It is made using Bevy, the Rust game engine, and the actual source for this game is just two files. In case you were living under a rock, Unity messed up and there are about a million videos about what happened. Here's a quick summary. They wanted a runtime fee for every install of a game made in Unity, above certain thresholds. This, quite understandably, caused a massive outrage and quite a lot of internet grief. They have since somewhat reverted the policy, but the loss of trust isn't quite as easy to get back. A couple of months ago, I released a video about a tool I called Unrust. It was a way for me to use Rust while making Unity games. It used a complicated mesh of tricks to get the Unity runtime to accept changes coming from the Bevy Rust source code. Took me, a Rust newbie at the time, quite a few attempts to get it to be ergonomic and just right, and there was a long way to go. But then Unity figuratively shat the bed quite hard and took my motivations to improve the library with it. Nobody wants the runtime anymore. In my Unrust video, my Unity-trained ass was wondering where the Bevy editor was. There are multiple crates and tools to get Bevy an editor, but I'm having a hard time leaving the Unity editor's sadistic embrace. Well, here's Unrust Part 2. Or Bevity, as I like to call it. I know. Shut up. New day, new name, new me. You make your game in Unity, define custom components in Rust, and they show up as mono behaviors. And when you click play, the Bevy runtime launches with your scene. Unity runtime what? To the dustbin with you. Nobody needs that anymore. The best part is that you can do play mode changes and see them happen in the Bevy game. Nothing like editing things on the fly to figure out game design. How does it work? It is, at its core, a Unity's YAML from hell to Bevy component parser. It reads the scene and translates that into entities and their components. There are C# scripts that expose the file path to GUID relations as JSON files for Bevity so that it can resolve the file references inside the YAML. A few recursive function calls later, turns out, you can rebuild the entire scene from YAML. The Unity editor also exposes events that you can hook into for change detection in the editor. Bevity's C# side translates that into JSON and sends it to the newly launched Bevy process through Standard In. The Bevity plugin is of course listening on Standard In, parsing the JSON and applying the changes. There are systems, only for when run through the editor, that print any changes in the Bevy game to Standard Out, and Unity is listening for these on its end and applying them in the editor. It is fairly simple, but there are two tricky things in there. The first is translating Unity component and object instance ID to Bevy entity ID. It is tricky because Bevy only knows about the local file ID defined in the YAML scene file, but a ton of digging and some helpful blogs later, global object ID was the key. There is some black magic trickery on top of it to get it to work with prefab IDs. The function has slow in its name, so you can imagine that this is not the most performant. But as an editor-only tool, this is great. The second thing is that Unity must not apply changes coming in from Bevy when Unity has just sent a change to Bevy. It must wait for an acknowledgement from the Bevy side, otherwise Bevy just clobbers the updated value with an old value. This is fixed using an extremely rudimentary acknowledgement system over the communication protocol. The good. Inbuilt primitives are done. You can use cylinders, planes, cubes, spheres, and capsules. Custom skyboxes are available if you arrange the textures in a particular way Bevy expects them. It can translate a few Unity built-in components to Bevy built-ins, and more are in the works. You can create prefabs and load them along with custom models in the GLTF format. Custom Bevy components show up as monobehaviors that you can attach to game objects. Physics also works by converting colliders and rigid bodies to components that work with the Bevy Rapier crate. Values are synced between Bevy and the Unity editor. The bad. There are so many built-in components in Unity that this is going to take a while. Only GLTF meshes are supported right now, which means installing a GLTF loader for Unity. Prefab spawning is a massive hackfest and needs to be improved. Prefab variants are hard, and I understand why it took Unity so long to implement them. Build times are starting to sting, and I need to cut down on the generics everywhere. Mesh colliders are tricky and don't always work, so use with caution. All materials are converted to Bevy's standard material, so that is very basic. Bevy's graphics capabilities, though impressive, are not close to what can be done with HDRP, so we need to manage our expectations in that department. Don't forget to subscribe so that you can be here when we hit that milestone. This is early days. I would not be too bothered with the performance. There are a ton of dumb clones in the code right now, which makes loading the scene ever so slow. But that's about it. I think the Bevy performance might be at par with what Unity is doing. I promise to do some benchmarks next time. Is this serious? As you can imagine, this is extremely rudimentary right now, but it already lets me make a small 3D platformer. Doing this in code is very painful and tedious, as you can see in a lot of Bevy example code. Unity's editor tools are quite nice to set such things up fast. I am planning to continue work on this. The source is linked in the description below. There are a lot of rough edges still, and there are nasty dragons under the hood. You have been warned. I'll do a game jam or two using this and round out features as I need them. Most of the art used in this video is from K. Luzberg. Go give a follow, like, donation, etc. The Bevy Discord is an awesome resource for anyone just getting into Bevy, full of helpful and supportive people. You know where to find me. Cheers.